From the moment of the Reboot's fresh promo image, everyone had one question on their minds. Why does Stinkfly look so different from his original counterpart? Although one of his original concepts, known as Dragonfly, was drawn as a bipedal and armored insect-like creature, the finalized version turned out to be more insect than anything else. Years later, his rebooted counterpart would enter the franchise and take a departure from the more insect side, albeit keeping most of his original powers. But why? Both Humongousaur and Wrath, although they differ from their originals, with Wrath being able to completely retract and draw his claws from his wrist, while also having claws on his fingers, and Humongousaur not being able to grow, but has the ability to create powerful shockwaves with his tail, both still resemble their original designs. In fact, all the reoccurring rebooted aliens do, except for Stinkfly. I believe there is a simple explanation for this, and it's called Metamorphosis. Of course, everyone remembers that their grade teacher explaining this to them. Metamorphosis is the dramatic change in which an insect goes through during their life cycle. In this case, we'll look at the caterpillar. When caterpillars are wrapped up inside their chrysalis, their bodies are broken down inside a liquid made from their own self and reformed, emerging from their slumber either as a butterfly or a moth. Sadly, nature doesn't let them decide, and there's no telling from looking at a caterpillar what they'll become after their transformation. I believe you can take this concept and apply it to lepidopteran species. During either their larvae stage or sometime after that, lepidopterans go through a metamorphosis of their own, like most invertebrate species, and either emerge as a butterfly or a moth. In this case, we'll call them Lepids A and Lepids B. Both species having the ability to fly, release poisonous gas, and shoot slime, but Lepids A is much more bug-like, having a green tone to their body, 4 eyes on the sides of their head, 4 flat legs, and are able to spew goo from their mouths and eyes, while Lepids B is more humanoid, with a blue-colored bioluminescent body, antennas, and orange wings. Much like moths and butterflies, both species respectively have their own routines, diets, environments, and even predators. We've seen multiple versions of the same species inside the atmosphere before, with the gourmands having Merc and Perk subspecies, so it's a pretty good possibility that the concept applies to lepidopterans. We also know that each and every DNA sample from the original continuity exists inside the reboot version of the Omnitrix, so maybe we'll see Lepids A somewhere down the line. Regardless, this was still a fun theory and video to make. If you want to leave a like, you can, and I'll see you when I see you.